The Alternative für Deutschland, Alternative for Germany, was born in 2013 and first opposed offering bailout packages to broke countries like Greece and Spain after the euro crisis. But by the time refugees from Syria and North Africa began to stream into Germany, the party had found its mojo. The AFD wants immigrants out. And tired of the political correctness that has ruled German public thinking for 70 years since the horrendous Holocaust, it rapidly found supporters. The AFD wants to seal all EU borders and send back most of the 1.5 million refugees already in Germany back to where they came from. But what about Indians? Armin Paul Hampel is a former television journalist who spent 11 years in India, whose kids were born in the country and at one point spoke only Hindi and no German. So does the AFD co-founder want to throw Indians too out of his country now?
You know, I've been living in India for about 11 years, and why should I change my opinion? And opinion of the Alternative for Germany, my AFD party, is not at all in that what you described. We have a problem with about 1 million people from Northern Africa migrating into Germany in 2015. That's a different story. You know that by the German constitution, we have to host people who are political refugees. And my AFD as well says they are welcome to come to our country. But this is just a percentage of maybe 15 or 20% from the about 1 million people. The rest of them have economical reasons in mind. And then my people and my party say, this is too much, we can't afford that, we can't finance them, and we have to find more and better solutions for these people who are trying to migrate from Northern Africa, from the Arab countries, from the Muslim countries into Germany. And India, by the way, is not affected at all.
Armin Paul Hampel says his party shuns the old boys club that all mainstream parties have become and is neither a left nor a right, but a party firmly centered. What's more, the AFD wants Germany to have an immigration policy so that educated professionals, including from India, can migrate smoothly. But Indians already in Germany are beginning to feel the heat of extreme right-wing groups that are emboldened by the emergence of the AFD as perhaps even the third largest party at the forthcoming poll. Last year, neo-Nazi violence upon foreigners was the highest in eastern Germany since 1990. Kulveer Singh, a resident of Mügeln, was a victim of such aggression. He and seven other Indians were chased by 50 men after listening to slogans of foreigners out at a fair. The men were beaten and had to hide in a pizzeria till the police cleared the mob.
Even when we were hiding, they shouted, "Foreigners, get out!" Of course we are scared. There are 50 men and we were just 8. That's a huge difference in numbers. They would have killed us if we have not hidden. They destroyed everything there too. The police saw it. If they have entered, we could have been dead. Even when we were hiding, they shouted.
One has to admit that the Second World War and the time of National Socialism in Germany still is a topic in our country. And a lot of people, because of this 12 years of German history, maybe reduce too much our history only on that 12 years. You know, we are about 1,200 years old as Deutschland or a German empire. So that we say it is a part of our history. Yes, we have to admit that it was a terrible part of our history, but we exist much longer than this 12 years. And our impression is that a certain number of people in Germany have a problem just to accept it. This. We have changed after 45 so much. Germany has taken over responsibility in all fields, and we accept our history. But that, and it is the same in India, when you reflect on your country and on your continent, that you have self-confidence and you are proud about your nation. And why should a German not be proud about his own nation when we have given the world so much, not in military things, much more in science, much more in music, much more in literature, and so on and so on. Architecture. So, and we say, be proud on that, rely on that. We don't have to think and to talk every time about 12 years, which were dark years in our history. There is some 1,200 years more where we can live happily with, and we can be proud on that. And maybe for some Germans, that's a problem. We don't have a problem with that.
Hampel says his party will not join any coalition but choose to sit in the opposition and learn parliamentarianism first to emerge the winner in the next general election slated 2021, he says. And inviting Indians to come and stay in Germany will go on, since the people the AFD really wants to throw out of Germany are others, he says, not those from India.
Unfortunately, you know, as a German-speaking country, people from India are not so much willing to go to a non-English-speaking country. But however, we invite them if they have a good qualification, if they have studied this or that, or if they are good engineers or are from the IT branch. Two big numbers, I mentioned it, about 1 million and more, with an ethnic, religious and cultural background which does not fit into our country, especially when they have a fundamental Islamic background, like you find it in the ES in Syria and Iraq. These people we do not accept over here. We want to live peacefully and happily in this country, and we don't want police each and everywhere, like in London, Berlin, Madrid or elsewhere, where you have to have fear that this day might be your last day. No, we want to keep out these forces, but this is a completely different story to that people we welcome in our country when they are, as I mentioned before, from India, for example, well-trained, well-educated. They are happily welcome. This is no problem for the Alternative for Germany at all.
Padma Rao, WION.